I'm standing here in front of one of the biological treasures of Mary's Peak, the prairie, the meadow, grassland. This is an example, a good example, of a habitat that used to be widespread in Western Oregon, but now most of it's been destroyed. This remnant here is one of the larger ones in Western Oregon, and it's in good quality. It's really great. As you've heard from other speakers, wildflowers are important components of the prairie, but don't just zero in on them. Look at their context. Look at the grasses, which are special. The prairie looks pretty uniform, but there's diversity out there. How many species of native grasses and grass-like plants do you suppose are out in that meadow? Well, I know that there's at least 10 different kinds of grasses and grass-like plants. One of my very favorites is Romer's Fescue. It's a native grass in Western Oregon here. Used to be dominant in the prairie all over the place, and now it's restricted to just a few small populations. Among the grass-like plants, we have Ross's sedge. Like most of the grasses, it produces flowers and seeds up on stalks, but it has kind of a trick. It also produces seeds down near the base. And these seeds have a soft, fleshy tissue that ants like to eat. So ants come up here, pick up the very conveniently located seeds, and drag them off to their nest. There, they eat the good parts and throw the seeds out. And this is a major way that these plants get dispersed. This cool, quite fuzzy little grass-like plant, Ludgula macrantha, didn't even have a name until 5 years ago. It's a special species of grasslands in Western Oregon. Kind of cool. Now, I love the grasses of Western Oregon, the grasses of this prairie. But I must say that I worry about them a lot, because the prairie is being invaded. Fortunately, people have stepped in to stop the worst invader, which is noble firs. Beautiful trees, they make spectacular forests. They don't belong in the prairie. When they shade the meadow, they kill off all our native prairie plants. So fortunately, they're being cut out. But there are other invaders that are harder to deal with. For example, red fescue. Non-native red fescue. Looks a lot like Romer's fescue, doesn't it? It's a little greener, it spreads a little more, and it sets a whole lot more seed than Romer's fescue does. It's coming in along the trails and spreading out from there. We don't know how far it's going to go, how much effect it's going to have on the Romer's fescue, but it can't be positive. So I worry. I worry about disturbances up here, like people driving on the meadow or making campfires that allow the invasives to come in. But then I come up here and just enjoy the beautiful grasses and the sky. It's a lovely place.